what is image and container. So image is basically a template which contains all the information or dependencies required for application to run. Okay, Docker image can be created by CLI or Docker file. First, we'll see how to create Docker image with the help of CLI, and then we'll move to the Docker file. So Docker ps command is to check what all the containers currently running. Okay, so since it's no container is running, it didn't show anything. So this is the official image from the Jenkins. Okay, so Jenkins have officially pushed this image. So I'm using this official one. As you can see, as 10 million plus pulls have been done. So in order to pull that image, you need to follow this command: Docker pull Jenkins or Jenkins. So this basically pull down this image onto our server. Here we execute this command: Docker pull. Now it is using default tag is the latest. Now if we didn't give any tag, then it will try to down pull the latest code. So first, when we execute Docker pull this command, first it will check for local, whether it's locally available, or else it will pull down from the server. So as you can see, that downloaded newer version of Jenkins. So this image, this latest version of this image has been downloaded. Now when you execute Docker, so in order to check the image, what all the image has been installed on the locally, so you would need to use Docker images image command. As you can see, this is the image name and the tag is latest one, and image ID, which is automatically randomly generated, and it gets also. So I think that if the developer pushed that newly updated one 6 days ago, this image has been created 6 days ago, and the size is 5 MB. Yeah. So now, if you want to see where this image has been stored locally, in which path, I'm going to take it to Docker info. So the Docker root directory is this one. Inside varlib Docker, it has been installed. And execute this utilization. How much space does this take? So you can check. As you can see, this consumed 580 meg. So this is how pull that image from the Docker repository, and then I'm running this image. Docker still there is no container is there here. Once image has been pulled out from the Docker registry, now I am trying to run this image. So we call this container, running the container from the image. So Docker run is a command to run the container. It will create and run the container, and I'm mentioning the port as well. Docker run hyphen d, sorry, hyphen p, p is the port. Now port 8080 colon 8080. Here the first 80 is the port on the host machine, and colon this one 80 is the port on the container. So what it will do is the container in the base machine, this machine port 8080 will be mapped to the container port 80. So what all the traffic coming on this machine on port 8080 will be forwarded to the port on container on 8080. So this is the mapping. This is the first is the container, sorry, host port, and second one is the container port. So the both the mapping has been done here, and then the image name is this one. So I can give the name as well. I want to name that container as Jenkins container. Then I hit enter. Now it's starting that Jenkins image. Now it is starting from that Jenkins image, trying to run the container. Now you can see here Jenkins is fully up and running. Move back to the browser and see. So first I need to get that public URL. So I'm running on 488. Now it's asking me for the password. In the container log, you will have password over here. You can install. Please use the following password to proceed to installation. And copy this one and paste it over here. To continue. Now you can install the CyScript plugin. So basically this is how we are doing for CLI installation.